Hello friends, I'm your host Gerald and welcome to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to see how to customize your UI based on the platform that you're running on in XAML. Let's have a look. Hey everyone, and welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to see how to customize your UI based on the platform that you're running on. So maybe you're running on iOS and you just want to have a slightly different padding than when you are running on Android for whatever reason. Or maybe you have a graphic that you want to show and should be different depending on if you're running on Android or iOS or Windows or any other platform that's supported, of course. That is something that you can absolutely do with the on-platform functionality in XAML in .NET MAUI. So let's just have a look. Here in Visual Studio, I created a file new .NET MAUI project, and I added a couple of things with the on-platform tag that I'm going to walk you through right here. So the first thing that you see is this Hello World label, and imagine that you want to give the text color a different value depending on the platform that you're running on. And that's exactly what we can do with this on-platform. So let me uncomment this. Let me remove the comments here. And you can see maybe this already doesn't look too familiar. Usually you just specify the properties of this label as these attributes right here. So you could just do text color and you can say the color right here, and that is how it works. But you can also specify the colors like this. So not make the label self-closing. And now we can say label.textColor, and we can have this on platform tag in here. Now the on platform tag says like, hey, I want to make a difference per platform. And then we have this on tag in here that actually has the platform attribute. And we can have multiple of those. So I can also have iOS in here and I can say, hey, it should be purple, and now it will be red on Android, purple on iOS, and all the other platforms will have the default value that you set on the on platform tag right here. Now, another thing that is important to note that you want to set the X type arguments. This is basically the object that you want to cast this value to. It's all XAML, it's all based on strings, so it's, you know, pretty good at inferring what type of object it should be. But in this case, you should help it a little bit and say, hey, the X type argument is going to be color. And then it also knows like, hey, I need to cast this blue to an actual color or red or purple, right? A little extra thing that you can do here is also if you want to have the same for iOS and Android, you can just do this comma separated values. And again, for all the other platforms, for instance, Windows, you can just have this blue color right here. So if I would run this on Windows, let's run it on Android first. The Android is the selected one. We would see the label text color would be red. Yes, very good. If you said red, you got the right answer. Because now we're running on platform and we're running on Android. And for Android, the value should be red. Now, if I switch over to Windows, what do we expect now? Blue. Really good. I like this pop quiz. I should keep that. So if we run this on Windows, there's no value specified. Well, not specifically for Windows, but we have this default value here, which is going to be blue, right? So we're going to have the blue value for Windows, and the Windows application is coming right up. And now we should see the same label, Hello World, but now the text should be blue. It might not be very clear on your screen, but it actually is blue. So there's that. Now, can we write this a little bit more compact? Yes, we absolutely can, because we have something that is called type converters in XAML. A lot of them are built in, so don't worry about it. And you probably already use them without knowing. So here, for instance, we have this image. And imagine that I want to show a different image depending on what platform we're running on. Now we can also do it like this. I've put it in the comment here above, so I can copy and paste it easily. So let me just paste this in here for the source and make the formatting a little bit nicely. And if I paste that here in the source, you can now see this is, this is a type converter. And here we can just say source as an attribute as you are, you know, used to. And now we can say, hey, we have these curly braces and we can say on platform. And whenever you don't put anything in front, this will be the default. You could also write it like this, default is. Now this will be the default. So whenever we didn't specify anything for a platform, this will be the one that's used, just a regular .NET bot. But if we have on Windows, on WinUI, now we have a value of Windows. And if we run on Android, we have this Android version. So what's going to happen now, if I run it on Windows, let's do that. we're going to see a Windows.NET bot. If we're going to run on Android, we see an Android one. And if we're going to run on iOS, we will just see the default.NET bot because I didn't include any special version for that here. So you can see the Microsoft logo in here. We have this Windows logo. Now, if I switch over to Android, you can see the same thing. Obviously, we can switch over to Android again, and we will see the .NET bot for Android. I'm not going to show you on iOS. You can do that at home. Nice exercise together with that pop quiz for you to do at home. But now you will see the regular .NET bot that's on there. And that's how you can specify these different on-platform values with just one line, basically. So depending on which syntax you like more, you can just do that. So now we have the red Hello World and the Android logo here in the .NET bot. So we have botception, if you will. Okay, so what do we have more? You can also use this in styles. So if you want to have, you know, you can put your styles in a separate XAML file so that you can keep your XAML nice and compact. So if we uncomment this, we can put it here in the content page resources. Let me just scroll down and see if that fixes the syntax a little bit. I have some preview version of Visual Studio, so that's why this is happening. And we have this resource dictionary, and inside of that we have styles. And here you can say, hey, target type button, and we can have this setter, and we can specify the background color for this. I also have a video on the styles and that kind of stuff, so find that on my channel as well. But for that setter, we can say, hey, background color, and now we're going to say, hey, again, on platform, X type arguments color, we're going to set yellow, and we have this WinUI and iOS, we're going to set it red, and for Android is going to be yellow. Now, I'm not going to run it again. You're going to trust me that this works, right? So that is how you can also do it in style. So there's all kinds of ways that you can actually use this and differentiate between the different platforms to make your layout look exactly as you want to on each platform. Of course, you can also do this in code. This is very much specific to XAML, but just to be very complete and also show you how to do this in code, if we switch over to the code behind, we have this device info APIs, and that has a property platform, which will tell you what platform we're running on currently. And then you can just make this equals or case statements, switch statements, or whatever you want to see, hey, device platform Android. All right, then we're running on Android and we're doing plus is 10. And you can make specific things, specific decisions based on the platform that is in here. And that's how you can make platform specific decisions based on the on-platform APIs in .NET MAUI. Another fundamental thing that you know about .NET MAUI, you just learned poof, it's in your head, you've learned it, and now you can apply it to all your applications. But did you know that you can also do it depending on idiom? So based on if you're running on a tablet or desktop or phone, you can make decisions as well. You can find the video for that right here, and I'll see you in that one.